Firstly, I'm very happy, guys, that the challenge which I gave you yesterday, some of you really took it and you really worked on that. The topic which I gave regarding the simultaneous elections in India, I can see here in the comment section, Jyoti Nayaka having come up with some of the points. Well done, Jyoti. Excellent here. Excellent attempt. I want you guys to start thinking, start doing brainstorming. The reason is, as the officers to be, you know, you need to have this analytical bent of mind. You need to start thinking from all the angles, you know, from all the dimensions. So this is one such attempt, guys. Okay, so keep going. With that, let's get to the first news of the day here. PM healthcare scheme from September 25th. Okay, now yesterday, if not all, at least most of us heard, you know, our Prime Minister's speech, where he actually explained the developmental things which has happened so far in his tenure. And one such thing is this Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan, guys, you know. Now, this Abhiyan, which is also called as a National Health Protection Scheme or Mission or Ayushman Bharat, is the world's largest healthcare scheme. Okay, now let's understand some of the features of this, you know, Abhiyan. It provides a cover of 5 lakhs per family annually. Okay, and it is benefiting more than 10 crore families, guys, which almost translates into 50 crore Indians. Just imagine, we are 130 crores people. You know, our population is 130 crores and 50 crores of them, that's almost translating into 40 to 45%. Now they are getting benefited from it. Okay, now the government is also planning to set up wellness centers, 1.5 lakhs wellness centers under this Abhiyan. Okay, now this Abhiyan will be launched on September 25th on pilot basis in 800 to 100 districts initially, and then later in the month of October or November it will be expanded to some more districts. Now, what is the eligibility? Who are eligible for this, you know, health protection scheme, guys? Only financially weak and underprivileged members of the society, and they should be registered under the socio-economic caste census of 2011. All right. Now, this is one of the very big news, guys, wherein almost 2 to 2.5% of our GDP will be invested in our healthcare programs, and this will eventually help us to get some good human capital here, which will help us to develop our economy. Okay, so with this, let's move to the next one. India's human space flight project. Wow, a big news. Now, we are planning to send a human into the space now, guys, you know, and we'll be the fourth nation after Russia, US and China to, you know, carry out something this huge. And the official name of this project is Gaganyaan, and VR Lalitambika, you know, she is a specialist in advanced launcher technologies. Now, she will be the director of the human space flight project. Now, this can be one of the examples for, you know, women empowerment. You know, if you get any questions in mains or perhaps in essay, you can use this as an example. All right. Now, what is this project all about? In 2022, that is 4 years down the line, we are planning to send 3 Indian astronauts from, you know, selected from Indian Air Force into the space to encircle Earth for 7 days from a distance of 300 to 400 kilometers. Okay, now the launch vehicle which will be used to send these astronauts will be GSLV Mark 3. Please remember this. Okay, and the launch pad, the place from where they will be launched, is Sriharikota. Refurbished launch pad at Sriharikota. We already have a launch pad. We shall refurbish it to suit the GSLV Mach 3 launch vehicle. Okay, and the project cost would be somewhere around 7,000 to 9,000 crores. So these are some of the points here, important points. So once this very mission is on, you know, on the roll, we shall cover it more. Okay, so let's move to the next one. Permanent Commission for Women Military Officers. It's a big news, guys. It's a big win for all our military, women military officers in the defense sector, and also to all our young girls who are dreaming to wear this uniform and serve our country, you know. Now, government is planning to expand categories in military for permanent commission for women officers. Now, this also can be one of the points in our women empowerment section or the category. All right. Now, till now, the recruitment used to happen under the short service commission. All right. Recruitment happened under short service commission for 14 years, guys. And whoever served this short service commission were not eligible for the pension. Okay. Now, this very permanent commission opportunity for women military officers is in the final stage under Defense Ministry, and very soon it will be on the papers. Now, having said this, currently permanent commission is available to women, okay, but only in three categories. One is education, legal branches, and the third is medical and dental services. And post this expansion, women can be a permanent commission officer in other categories also. All right, so next one. RBI scrutinizing 200 stressed accounts. Now, RBI is examining whether banks have followed prudential norms in respect of these stressed assets. They want to check if banks have taken any steps regarding containment of the proliferation of this NPA, guys. You know, whether they have taken any steps to reduce or stop the NPA. Okay, so what exactly is this NPA? What is the stressed assets all about? All right, let's look into it. Stressed assets is the summation of NPAs, that is non-performing assets, restructured loans and return of assets. Now, you can pause the video and go through the slide here or the video here. You can get the definition, but however, I'll explain you through the example now. Let's say a company ABC has taken loan from State Bank of 100 crores on 20% interest. All right. Now, this company ABC has to pay back this amount plus the interest within 1 year. Okay, so by next August 2019, they have to pay this 100 crores plus 20% interest on that. Now, let's say the company fails to pay that back and company takes 3 more months time to actually pay that back. Let's say 3 more months means September, October, November. So even by November 2019, if company fails to pay the money back, then that very money or that very loan is actually called non-performing asset. All right. Now, post that, a bank would propose to the company, with an intention that if not 100 crores or if not 20%, at least pay 10% interest or 15% interest, right? Something is better than nothing, right? So at least pay that. So they will restructure the loan accordingly so that at least some money is gotten by that. And that very loan, restructured loan or the restructured money again is added to the NPA. Okay, now the last category, that is return of assets, are those assets wherein a company would declare itself as a bankrupt and they would say that they have nothing to actually pay them off. So those assets are added in the return of assets category. So the summation of all these three would be stressed assets. Okay, now if you have any doubts, guys, so just leave me a comment here. I shall come up with a separate video on this. So let's look at the latest report here, guys. The gross NPAs have risen to 10.3 lakh crores, which was 8 lakh crores in March 31st, 2017. So over a period of time, over a period of 1 year, there is an increase of 2.3 lakh crore rupees. So it's a very serious thing. And this will take us to the challenge here, a write-up challenge. Now, I'll give you a topic here, guys, and you have to come up with some kind of information, some kind of write-up here, which should be in between 150 to 200 words, and post it in the comment section. Okay, now the topic here is NPA issue in Indian banking sector. So let's see how many of you would participate in this, do some kind of brainstorming, and this will eventually help you to better yourselves up for the mains or the essay writing. Okay, so with that, let's call it a day now. And once again, I wish you all the best. See you tomorrow.